Hey there everyone, welcome back to my channel once again. Here it's Mack, and as always the whole gameplay commentary video here once again is Terminator Resistance. So before we continue on here, I just want to say once again everyone, thank you very much for tuning in to my channel here, and especially for the newcomers who have subscribed to my channel. Very much greatly appreciate that. Please keep up with that type of awesome type of effort and work. That does very much help me out, and hopefully I can get this channel up and growing and be spontaneous in various ways. All the same, thank you very much. Please keep that nice support. Greatly appreciate that. Alright, let's go ahead and kick this off. Okay, so now we're pretty much heading back towards the whole downtown area of LA. And there's going to be some things that I'm just going to try and briefly cover here prior to moving out of the whole downtown area and moving forward. It's just going to be mentioning about some of the previous types of objectives that Jacob Azoria has achieved and putting in little fun facts here and there. Anyways, here we go. Alright, now we're back in this tourist area here. So okay, so pretty much prior to me starting off this whole type of gameplay here, my first thought was, I hope I don't lose my train of thought here, because I know there's going to be much going to be mentioning about here anyways. Okay, so as far as I do know of, what I do know is that if I had to make a bit of a rough type of calculated percentage type of a guess here per se, I'm probably gonna say that now we pretty much have reached like around, give or take, roughly about anywhere between 75, like three quarters done, or 75%. Percentage already done on this gameplay here, or possibly just a smidget over, like a little bit over, because I know that for example Jacob here has a few more types of missions to get done, and then boom, he's done. He's already home free type of deal. Everything's all good. So just gotta mention here that there's, like I said before, there's gonna be there's going to be a few little type of objective clips I'm just going to briefly expose, so that way, yeah, there it is. I'm going to briefly expose as to saying, like, in the whole previous parts of what Jacob had already done, and then going to show a bit of a fun fact of things and then move forward here. So again, this is going to be a little fun fact of something that I'm going to show all of you here, just for the hell of things here. Okay, so first of all, one second here, just going to go back in here so that way that HK may not spot me. I thought I had taken that thing down. That didn't make any sense. So anyways, here I'm just going to go to a certain type of section on this type of little level here. Just going to show you guys something here. Alright then, now, I don't know if any of you do recognize this part of the area or not. I'm pretty sure all of you do. This is kind of like at the fair beginning here when Jacob kind of emerged somewhere out of here and was pretty much making his way pretty much like up there to shoot a bunch of like scout drones and to meet up with that Lady Vengeance woman, and then he kind of pretty much came around over here and took care of, one second here. Took care of a bunch of T-800 Terminator machines and other machines, like, over in that section over there. Now, again, I'm not too sure if all of you do recognize this part of the area or not, but just, again, my own personal kind of a fun fact of things here is, okay, so according to the clips of which I'm about to show you here, if I'm stepping, okay, there we go. According to the clips of which I'm about to show you here, Again, this is kind of like a little fun fact type of connection here. Okay, now keep in mind this is from the very this is from the very beginning of my intro, of which I customized in one of my videos called Part 1 Intro and the Beginning. And keep in mind, like these two clips right here, they've already had been recorded, so you'll probably end up hearing me say something a little bit like the same thing from the beginning. It's been repeated. So, okay, I'm pretty sure once again all of you do remember these two separate clips here. How exactly did a city like, well, pretty much like this kind of city right here, how did it turn from, going back to that camera angle here, looking like all of this to all of this? Yep. As you just finished seeing, this area right here, and if I do angle the camera up a little higher, like so, and just watch the pattern here. Yep. See, that's exactly what it is. So pretty much what I'm trying, which I am displaying on here, is that according to those two clips which I just finished exposing, this is the area here of where I shot it. Where I shot that portion of that gameplay, part of that, this is pretty much where I shot the scene here, is in this area right here, which, like, again, once I angle the camera upward like this, you should be able to recognize it. I thought, yeah, that's kind of cool. I'll just show that for the hell of things here anyways. Okay, so now, again, I just wanted to expose that for the hell of things. So, besides that part, I'm pretty sure all of you recall that pretty much according to the previous objective, especially on the last two videos here that I had done, that one of the side objectives of which Jacob had to do was help this woman out right here. But unfortunately, like every other type of war kind of a sacrifice, it was unfortunately a bit too late. Such as the side mission objective, which was Lady Vengeance here.
Jesus.
The central core is not located here, but Jacob did manage to, as a side mission, take down one of Skynet's outposts.
Was destroyed.
Affirmative. Did I use that correctly?
And finally, on this level here, hitting the main mission objective, which was taking down this HK tank and destroying it, just to download and obtain Skynet's latest security codes.
HK 7.
Good job, Rivers. Download the security code and get out of there. I didn't take a nap. That was exhausting.
All right, here we go.
Got it. Moving out.
Now that Jacob has Skynet's latest security codes, which means that can be used to unlock Skynet's second generation plasma weapons, he can now take the codes to Mack, and Mack can do this.
I've got the codes.
All right, then let's get right to it. Please insert stolen security codes now. Strike a key when ready. And it's done. Like they say, easy money.
That's it?
With the proper equipment, it only takes a moment. We can fight Skynet with our own weapons.
I've already sent all the blueprints and access codes to Connor. Grab that plasma behind you. And go see Baron.
As for the NeuroNet CPU processor chip, which is used by a T-800 and up, such as a Terminator machine and a Terminator infiltrator.
I thought I told you, I can't work with so much noise, I need absolute silence, so please stop that.
That will be discussed when meeting with Dr. Mack. Okay, now pretty much just kind of give the whole overall type of info here. All of the side missions and the main mission has been taken care of. This whole level here has already been dealt with and taken care of. So that's going to imply Jacob can now officially go ahead and take off. And as you can see by that icon right there, that's the way out. And this is where we can now freewheelingly take off, no problem. Okay, so by the way, I'm just going to also briefly mention about this here, is that on this particular video here, I may not necessarily be able to promise any kind of automatic, like a boom gameplay type of action, because there's going to be quite a bit of info to cover, and there's also going to be a little bit of my own type of logical input that's going to be covered into this, and a certain key type of highly emphatic kind of critical sections of the game that's going to, you know, in a logical sense display and as to why to turn the tide of various types of people's destinies for the better, as opposed to not looking at it carefully, we miss the whole opportunity, and guess what? Things go pretty much, you know, shit goes downhill from there. So on this video here, maybe not, but we'll see. But on the next video here for sure, because I'm going to be calculating as to when I'll be doing this section, and hopefully I can power through the whole gameplay type of action through another section. So this video here, it may be a bit long, who knows, because we are, Jacob himself here, Sergeant Jacob Rivers is getting fairly close, decently close to the end. And towards the end, I'm going to be exposing more detail and depth as to, like, if you choose about this route, this is going to happen. Choose this route, this is going to happen. Choose this route, this is what's going to happen. It's all about the whole choices of which way you're going to go. Okay, so now, since now literally everything is all done in this section here, that is going to imply, let's roll out. And here we go. It wasn't easy, but I got those security codes for Dr. Mack. With them, he should be able to access Skynet's mainframe and hack that plasma rifle that should level the playfield. And yes, I should be able to, and yes, he should be able to pull those off now. Now, as for the whole part of Skynet security codes, the CPU chip, and Dr. Mack, I'm going to be going through a bit of a very logical type of detail briefing about that, because it's one of those type of key critical type of choices that you're going to be making. So for those who have played this game, you know exactly what I'm talking about. To those that have never touched this game before, you'll be able to see what I'm talking about. Here we go. All right. Yep, I can feel that vibe. This is gonna be one of those key critical type of key moments. Now, since we're already back in Mack's shelter, I was thinking of Baron's shelter. No, that's not it. Since we're already back in Dr. Mack's shelter here, and his shelter is in the Hollywood Hills, I believe correctly. Yes, it is within the Hollywood Hills. And he's not paying a high price for a big house or anything, because he's already in this underground section here. Anyways, as for those three topics, let's go ahead. All right, here he is. Let's make this happen.
I've got the codes.
All right, then let's get right to it. Please insert stolen security codes now. Strike a key when ready. And it's done. Like they say, easy money.
That's it?
With the proper equipment, it only takes a moment. We can fight Skynet with our own weapons. I believe that goes for that infiltrator as well. The first prototype just came out a couple of days ago. Imagine what happens if they become mass-produced. We need to hurry before that happens.
That infiltrator has been after us for more than just a couple of days.
What do you mean?
It's been following me for months.
But that simply can't be. That prototype has been out for mere days.
It's the same model that destroyed Pacific Division.
But I'm connected to Skynet's mainframe and I can see their plans. I'm telling you that what you're saying is not possible. Unless... Oh my God. They will do it. They will finish the TDE.
Finish what?
TDE, time displacement equipment. For all intents and purposes, it's a time machine.
A time machine?
Yes, a time machine. You go in, you pick a date, you press a button, and just like that, you'll be watching your younger self learning to tie your shoelaces. You know, time travel. Skynet's been working on TDE for a while now. I've been monitoring its progress, but it's still not ready yet.
So how could they send anyone back if it's not ready?
They didn't, but they will. Don't you see? In one alternative future, they finished TDE and sent a Terminator back to our times. That has to be the one you saw. You couldn't have seen it otherwise. It didn't exist yet. That would explain why they suddenly started to learn at such a geometric rate. This is big. This is really big.
So if it's done, then what the fuck can we do now?
We can still fight for this future. Our future. You could stop Skynet before they finish building time displacement equipment and send any more Terminators back. I'm forwarding everything I've learned to Connor. He needs to know. And you go report back to Baron.
Speaking of Baron...
Ask Mack about Baron.
What happened between you and Baron?
Years ago, Connor gave an order to infect Skynet with a virus. To do it, we had to reboot a T-800 model I was trying to reprogram. I warned them that I wasn't done and that the Terminator was fully functional, but they didn't listen. So, as expected, it went online and sent our coordinates to Skynet. But not only that, it attacked and killed Perry. Baron took it personally because they were an item. She's been holding a grudge ever since.
All right. Okay, now that we are in front of Dr. Mack here, face to face, mind you, believe it or not, this moment in time between Dr. Edwin Mack and Sergeant Jacob Rivers here is another highly critical emphatic key point in time that needs to be focused on and changed for the better. Now, at this very key critical moment in time right now between Edwin and Jacob here, considering you are with Dr. Mack right now within his shelter, Commander Jessica Barron right here, away from prying eyes and ears, orders a hit by secretly ordering Jacob to kill Dr. Edwin Mack right here.
I need you to get rid of Mack. He's unpredictable. He sabotaged our mission and killed our men before. I cannot let it happen again. I need you to kill him as soon as he reprograms that rifle.
So that's going to mean she wants Jacob, as in you, the player, to make like an assassin, a hitman, like Agent 47 here. And let's not confuse his number with the colossal and intimidating looking T-47. Barron wants Jacob to make like a hitman, like Agent 47 here, and kill
shit.
Target down.
Yes, just like the last clip you just saw, as soon as Mack is done using those security codes and reprogramming the second generation plasma weapon, she wants Jacob and has ordered him to kill this man right here. In a logical sense, I would advise against that. If you do choose to kill Dr. Mack here, let's just say here is the aftermath, or rather the cause and effect of things, if you do choose to kill Mack for Barron, regardless if she orders Jacob to do it or not. And as I do show the clips, pay close attention to the actions and dialogue of these characters.
What are you doing?
Did Commander Barron order you to do this?
Please, please think about it. I'm the only one that can stop Skynet. You need me.
The second one will seek to destroy the T-1000.
T-1000?
A Terminator made of mimetic polyalloy. Sent back to kill me as a child. A single prototype created by Skynet. It's too powerful for a single human being. That's why we'll have to send a Terminator of our own. Do you have that CPU that Mack reprogrammed?
No, I don't.
You don't? Now we've got a problem. I don't believe any of our soldiers are capable of stopping the T-1000. We'll have to find another way. We have to do it soon.
There was no way a human could stand up against the more advanced T-1000. But without Dr. Mack to reprogram an infiltrator CPU, Connor would be forced to find another way to get a machine on our side.
So that would be the negative cause and effect of things if you did kill this man right here. And long after that, even Jacob would be questioning as to though if he even did the right thing or not, regardless if he was carrying out Barron's order.
I executed Mack. Baron was convinced that he was a threat to our cause. As a soldier, I've been taught to obey orders. But this time, I wasn't sure if it was the right decision.
That was the part of which I had mentioned before about the NeuroNet CPU processing chip for a T-800 Terminator machine and Terminator Infiltrator. Although Jacob does have the chip on him, you have to keep in mind as well, but if Dr. Mack here is dead, here's a logical question here for you that we have to think about this further in depth here is, who can reprogram the chip besides Dr. Mack? We all know Dr. Alvin Scott is a lab techie guy himself, but there are doubts if he can at all reprogram the chip or not. So in other words, if you kill Mack here, that chip will never get reprogrammed, and you'll never get a T-100 Terminator machine on your side as an ally to send back in time as a protector for John Connor against the T-1000. You keep Mack alive. He can reprogram the chip. That chip now has a great value and purpose for the Resistance to send a Terminator machine back in time to execute that mission. That purpose, which is to protect the very young John Connor against the T-1000. So that's just how it is. Mack needs to be kept alive. If you kill him, that ship is technically useless because it's never been reprogrammed, and you're pretty much, shit out of luck right there. You keep Mack here alive, the chip can be reprogrammed, and guess what? You got yourself a T-800 Terminator machine right on your side to do your bidding, and then boom, the young version of John Connor will be safe and alive. So instead of going with the whole option of kill Mack, you're going to disobey Baron's order, but, this is going to be for the logical good, because a lot of promising things will come out if you, a greater type of result, and a lot of promising things will come out, if you keep Mack alive and have a T-100 Terminator machine on your side and protect John Connor if you do this.
I got that chip for you. Is it any different from the others?
Is it any different? Of course it is! Its CPU is a neural net processor, a learning computer. It's been updated to incorporate infiltrating techniques. Thus, its processing power exceeds any other chip. This could be exactly what we need to win this war, Jacob.
I have to warn you. Baron sent me to kill you. If she finds out that I didn't, she'll send someone who will.
Thank you for telling me. If what you're saying is true, I don't have much time. As soon as I'm done packing, I'll be on my way. I've already sent all the blueprints and access codes to Connor. Grab that plasma behind you, and go see Baron.
Well, you couldn't complete the job as so-called Agent 47. But again, for more of a better promising type of results, especially in the long run, this is for the better. Because now, towards the end, things will be much better. Alright. Now, so I'll leave this guy right here to reprogram the chip. Well, he probably did, and Jacob already has it on him, but whatever. I'm pretty sure all you do get the meaning behind that. And... oh, wait a minute. Damn it. Shit. Okay, well, in that case, I'll have to... damn it. Well, these two don't really have much of any value to me. So, okay, one second here. This is what I'll do. Sorry, I wasn't really necessarily quite thinking this through anyways. Okay, drop this. I don't really use that. I guess I could, but at the same time, it's like, yeah. Yeah, whatever. Toss it. If Edwin over here wants to use it, it's up to him, whatever, I don't care. So? Oh yeah. The Plasma Rifle V-25A. This is gonna kick a lot of ass. There you go, folks. Everything exactly planned out as it is. Now, another primary mission objective against time. What the hell is this? Oh! I didn't even notice this before. Journey entry, weak spot. They have a weak spot. They are tirelessly dedicated to carrying out the mission they were programmed to do. They will give themselves away if there is even a slight chance that they will get what they want. They never miss or let go of any opportunities, and when they do, they stand there exposed for what they truly are: heartless killing machines. Well, yeah, perhaps so, but that doesn't necessarily mean that there's a weak spot to take them down, like, more quickly and efficiently. But whatever. Alright, let's take off. And let's get this over with.
Commander.
I'm here. Is the thing with Mack taken care of?
It is. But I have some news for you.
Go ahead.
So, it turns out that the infiltrator that's been following me has been sent back in time through a time displacement equipment. It connected to Skynet and uploaded all its knowledge, causing them to learn at a geometric rate. I have a feeling this war will not last much longer. And he's right, it won't. The war will come to a closing end, but unfortunately, there's going to be a bit of bigger multiple costs just to end the war. Alright, here we go. Alright, now that we're back here, and this is where that Jacob and the rest of the TechCom soldiers, like I mentioned a few videos back, as to them getting all primed up, marching through that entryway door, and going to their final type of so-called outpost to try and to take out the central core, which powers Skynet. Bit of a mild spoiler alert, sorry folks, but that's not gonna exactly plan out the way they had. It's pretty much not gonna go down the way they had planned it. And since all of you have played this game before, I'm pretty sure you know exactly what I'm talking about. Yeah, it's gonna suck. Because while Jacob and the rest of his TechCom forces are out there, that's when Skynet creates its own type of a separate invasion, come barging in here and into this part of this shelter and whack everyone out. By the way, I'm sure all of you remember that whole 99.5 or 0.8 percentage of people being whacked out and killed into the shelter here. One does survive, and that's Baron. All right. Now, before we do, proceed onward here. Now, for this part here, we have about one more type of history or destiny to change. I don't know if there's a few more that I can think of at the top of my head, but one at the top of my head for sure that Jacob here needs to change. So, considering previously Jacob already managed to change Aaron's destiny just to keep her safe and alive.
Your husband left for Mexico.
What are you talking about?
I found this letter in your house. It's from Peter. It says that he's heading there to look for you.
He couldn't find me when I was right under his nose. How's he gonna find me in Mexico? What a sweet fool.
You should go look for him.
You're right. I have to find him before he hurts himself. Baron's not gonna like that, but she never scared me. Thank you for finding him for me, Jacob.
And the same thing with Ryan.
What the fuck, Rivers? What'd you think would happen, huh? Baron's kicking me out. That what you wanted? I'm a dead man.
Yes, he's most likely still pissed at Jacob, but little does he know what Jacob did for him is going to keep Ryan safe and alive, especially in relations to Skynet's upcoming invasion, attack into this shelter here without Jacob and the rest of the TechCom soldiers even knowing about this. Because, as it is, according to Skynet's upcoming invasion, Skynet's going to be bringing some of its Terminator machines inside here, whacking everyone out, including if Ryan was down there, he would have been killed too. So again, it's like, little does Ryan know as to what Jacob had done for him. It's all leading towards the better. It's all leading towards a better result of keeping Ryan and the rest alive. And that's what Jacob did. Okay, let's go ahead.
Here's the man of the hour.
Sergeant, are you taking a tour with us?
So some of these guys will be coming along with Jacob, and others may be staying behind, but we'll see. And keep in mind, this is going to literally be the last time that Jacob comes back here when everyone is alive and well. Yes, folks, this is going to be the last time that Jacob Rivers, Sergeant Rivers, comes back here with his squad or platoon or whatever, or legion or whatever, or brigade, or however you want to pronounce that. In other words, with a colossal amount of numbered TechCom soldiers, as they are alive and well, but after the invasion, everyone's going to be whacked out. Saddening, really. Nice knowing you, buddy. You too, Scoopy. This could be one of those sad type of moments, I tell you. One moment here. I'm just going to quickly do something. There we go.
Repeat it back to me.
Know your target and what's behind it.
And what else?
Shit, I forgot.
All right. Hey, is that Max? Hey, Poochie, what's going on here? Anyway. And most likely, Patrick's little art display.
I think these ones have a 5-second fuse.
Are you sure? We don't want the same thing that happened last time.
You need anything?
Can I see your hardware?
All right, now, time to clear some of these things out. So I've already got one of these, so I can officially get rid of. Oh, a thousand coin. I did mention that. I grabbed this just to like sell it off. My first thought is, I'm pretty sure this is going to be a nice little decent kind of high value. For sure enough, I was right. Hmm. 600? Yet the other type of plasma rifle was at was like 400 or something like that. A 1,000. Really? Well, whatever. I'm taking it out of there. Yep, time to sell everything off, get rid of all of it. Okay, so plasma. Wait a minute, I can get this damn thing? Okay, so pretty sure I got everything that I need, at least anyways. Okay, so I'm gonna... damn it. There we go. I thought I could do that. Yes, I thought I could do that. Excellent. Oh, this is too sweet and nice. I thought I could sell some of these off. Okay, I'm just going to go to a bit of a, like a little, kind of a jump cut here, so I can kind of get everything all sorted that I need. Just one moment here. Okay, so I just finished making some adjustments here, and as you can tell, I sold literally a shit ton of the Skynet ships. Just a crap load of them. All been sold. Well, I sold like all the ones that I feel as though I may not need, so I figured I'll just go ahead and get rid of these. There are some upgraded ones, like these blue kind. Figured, well, no, I think I'll be fine without those. And there's a few other ones, like, but it's mostly just these common ones and these blue ones right here. So I pretty much got rid of as to what I feel as though I can pretty much part without. And so pretty much what I already had done, I'll just so pretty much like managed to organize what I felt as though I could get rid of. And figure, well, I'll just keep a little bit behind just in case. Who knows? So that's already been taken care of and done. So just to kind of briefly show this here. So this violet type of plasma rifle, I'm gonna keep around just to be safe. Who knows? There's a red one, but I'm gonna keep around just in case. I probably won't need to, but it's like, yeah, who the hell knows? So managed to switch it off with this here plasma rifle V25A. I would have to change the clip. It's like, whatever. I'm not overly concerned. I guess I'll have to deal with that. And let's see here. Got myself a plasma minigun VSB-90. This one uses violet plasma cells. Now the thing is, I would have to change out the clip with on this one here until I do scoff or steal another type of plasma, another type of violet plasma minigun like this. AT-850 type of Terminator infiltrator will have it. I'll just take it down and just take that one off of that one. So I managed to do that because I'm going up against a huge battle. Might as well. And what else here? Oh yes, and a new type of rail plasma type of sniper rifle. This one shoots out violet plasma cells as opposed to a red one. Well, it's gonna help anyways. And well, the laser guided missile, nothing special about that one, but I still have it with me. Oh, and by the way,
Do you need anything?
One last thing.
Can I see your hardware?
I forgot to grab and take. Damn it. Figure I might as well do this now. No. Missile with the laser guide. Should be able to do it. There. All loaded up. Should be all nice. Now I figured with the type of, with the whole med kit such as this and this one right here. But figured, well, considering the fact that my health regenerates, because I'm already at that high enough skill, I should be able to do that. I figured, well, I should be okay. As long as I'm quite tactful enough, I should be able to preserve these and only take one only if I need to. Okay. Let's go ahead. And as you also can tell, it's going to quickly show you something here. All stealth, all weapons, all explosives, all been good in that area. Lockpicking, hacking. Like I said, this was not all that hugely important, but, well, because I'm already leading it to the last. Like, I guess I'm going to go ahead and just fill it up because the points are going to be coming on in anyway. So it's like, what the hell, I guess. Backpack is maxed, toughness is good, fast learner is at its peak. So, hell, I'm laughing. You're laughing, you got nothing to worry about. Okay, let's see here, what do I need to... Do I need to talk to this guy about anything, or what? How about that? A lab tech guy is carrying one of those.
They gave me a rifle? I don't even know how to use one. They said it's hot, but it doesn't seem hot to me at all.
All right. Okay, I thought maybe there was a few other people down there. I guess not. Alright. Here is so-called, Jacob's, commander slash side chick.
Rivers, just when you thought shit couldn't get any more crazy, this happens.
So what now?
With the infiltrators coming out and news of a fucking time machine, Connor wants to finish this war fast.
Are we prepared?
Nowhere near. That's why an all-out attack is our only option. Alvin managed to locate Skynet's central core through the hijacked satellite. It turns out it's right under our nose. It's in the basement of the old Griffith Observatory.
So we're moving out?
You are. Connor wants me to stay here to coordinate the attack. And his North Division is heading to stop Skynet from sending anything through the time displacement equipment.
So this is it?
It does seem that way. You better get all your things sorted. Take your time. You're leaving in a couple of hours. Dismissed.
All right. Oh, by the way, I also forgot to mention about this, my little fault on that one here. Now when it comes to these type of incoming type of invasion and attacks and such, now, well, since Aaron and Ryan are out of Skynet's upcoming invasion, now that just leaves one important person's type of destination to change.
If you hadn't found us back in Pasadena, I don't know what would have happened. Well, actually I do. Exactly what the others said would happen.
Yep. Jennifer, the scavenger, and Jacob's little cutie pie. She is coming up next here. Or rather, coming up right away. And I know that Patrick should be around. Probably around that corner, I'm probably gonna guess here anyways. And see, there he is right there. There is Patrick.
Jacob, you're moving out?
I am. What about you?
I'm part of a scavenging team now, but Commander Baron gave us an order to get back to the shelter. If you see Jennifer, can you tell her that?
Okay. Where is she?
Last time I saw her, she was upstairs.
Okay. And for what you're about to change, you're gonna keep this young man here alive and keep his little poochie Max here alive. Alright, here we go. Gentlemen, on behalf of Sergeant Jacob Rivers, it was a pleasure serving with you. All right. Yeah, that was a bit a little silly, but hey, like I said, the invasion is coming. Little do these soldiers know about the invasion coming up. That is rather saddening. Okay. Here we go here. Oh yeah, I forgot about that. Not every day I do access that. Ooh, cool setup. Yeah, this is the way. I can't believe I just said that. I made that like that Star Wars character the Mandalorian said, "This is the way." Oh, I'm sorry, but that was just too funny. Cool, kick-ass type of setup here. She shouldn't be that far now. Light off. And there she is. Now everything has been led up to this moment and beyond that. Her history, her path, her destiny is going to be changed for the better. Time to put right that once went wrong.
Nice view.
How did you find me?
Patrick told me you might be somewhere around here.
It's my thinking spot. Is he worried?
No, he seems happy. How did he do on your first scavenging hunt together?
Well, at first he was excited just to be outside. A little too excited. Some drones spotted him. But I did it. I managed to protect him. Nothing happened. And from that point on, he understood how dangerous a scavenger's life can be.
See, you'll make a great scavenging team.
Yeah, I'm starting to see it that way. And because of that, I was thinking...
About leaving?
I don't have any secrets from you, do I? Yeah, about leaving. With Patrick.
All right. Everyone, this is it. The so-called the final it, per se, of changing anything for the better. This is literally it. Okay, now that Jacob here is face-to-face with his little cutie here, Jennifer, for the last time on this game for now... Now, I'm pretty sure we all know how this goes. We've already have gone through this before plenty of times. If you do, convince her to stay when Skynet's invasion is just literally, you know, right around the corner. Once again, this is what's going to happen to her if you convince her to stay.
You know, I think you should stay. This is not a time to think about personal problems. There's a war to fight.
Spoken like a true soldier. But you know what? You're right. It's probably incredibly selfish of me to even consider leaving. Especially now this war is about to end. I'll stay. Support the cause. Maybe even start faking enthusiasm while talking to Baron.
Jennifer and Patrick died at the hands of Terminators in the shelter. I wish there was something I could have done to make them leave.
Yes, that is the result of her deathly type of destiny. That is the result of the ending of her fate right there. Like Aaron and Ryan, she gets killed within that shelter foreshadowed by the invasion. Skynet's invasion, that is. And You know, that's the whole thing about the whole part, especially from the last clip, is guilt or regret is one of those very depressing and very painful type of punishments that we do inflict upon ourselves, that we always think, you know, what if I could have done this, or what if I could have done that, or if only if I could have done this, or only if I could have done that. And something like that, that does weigh heavy upon all of us. And that's not something that's very easy to shake off. So for Jacob here to literally correct this, to literally change history and change her destiny and put right that once went wrong, Jacob is gonna go with this.
I think you should leave.
What? Are you serious? I thought you'd be the last person to encourage me to go. What about what you said earlier? What changed?
Things are different now. It's not safe here anymore, and I think you should go.
Jacob, I don't know what to say. You know that your opinion matters to me the most. To be honest, you're the only thing keeping me here. Well, that's it then. I guess I'm going. You're always looking out for me. Thank you for that. I know you're moving out soon, but there's something I want to say. Regardless of what happens later, I hope that we'll find each other. Thank you for always being there for me. I'm lucky to have someone like you.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, this is going to be one of those types of, it's going to be metaphorically like, not exactly an X-rated type of a scene, but this is going to be somewhat kind of like a rated R type of a scene. Here we go.
And I'm lucky to have you.
I hoped you'd say that. You know what? I'll stay here just a little while longer. Tell Patrick not to worry. I'll be back soon.
I'll do that.
Well, now, Jacob did manage to get his so-called rocks off for the second time. Well, she doesn't know about it, and, well, she doesn't have to know about that, really. Anywho, she's going to rest up for a little bit, and she's going to take off. And that's the part I'm going to end up saying. Congratulations, everyone. You just managed to change history for the better and change her destiny, so now a Jennifer herself is going to stay safe and stay alive. Long before, and pretty much, she's going to be able to stay safe, stay alive, and she's going to be long gone, long before Skynet's upcoming invasion. Okay. Well, I should say both Jennifer and Patrick, but then again, I'm pretty sure all of you get my meaning behind that. I'm not gonna lie, this is a really nice, beautiful type of little scene right here. Regardless if everything is all in wreckage or whatever, rubble. This is actually pretty sweet, really nice to even look at this. And you can't even see the moon. It's probably just foggy out. Okay, I should get back on point here. Later, sweetheart. Okay, and by the way that I'm going to be planning the end here... Yeah, you are going to be... Yeah, Jacob is going to get back with her again. I don't think I can... No. There we go. And Commander Baron herself right there. Let's go ahead and kick this off.
You ready to move out?
Let's go for it.
I am.
All right, let's do this. Thirty years ago, the machines decided to wipe out all of humanity because they feared that we were a threat to their existence. Today, we make their fear come true. Sergeant Rivers, you were requested by John Connor to lead the Alpha Team. You will be responsible for carrying out the attack on the location of Skynet's central core. We will create a diversion to lure out any HK aerials patrolling the area. That should give you some time to breathe. Taking out Skynet's ground forces, that's on you. Remember, the goal is to destroy Skynet's central core, at whatever cost. Good luck out there. Dismissed.
Observatory. We're heading to the old Griffith Observatory to carry out an attack on the central core, Skynet's main reactor. This is it. If we want to stop Skynet, we need to destroy the central core. Yeah, but little does both the future Jacob / the stranger and the present Jacob both know as to what's not right with this. Here we go.
Team Alpha, this is Team Bravo. Skynet's taken the bait. Good luck out there.
All right, everyone, this is us. Let's move out. We're 2 minutes out from the observatory. As soon as we get past that barrier, expect Skynet to show up.
So, yep, like I mentioned in and some of the previous videos that I had already produced. I'm sure all of this looks familiar to you all. This is a very big kind of emphatic type of outpost. But anyway. Here we go.
Now stay focused. Silverfish! 12 o'clock!
By the way, cool type of plasma rifle.
Neutralized! Let's keep moving!
Nah, probably not. Let's get going here.
Metals ahead!
Nice shot! We're through!
Okay, I'm gonna see what I can collect here. Okay, never mind. It's all good. Let's go ahead. Oh! Nah.
Keep pushing forward! Metals! Shooting.
Just like clockwork, baby. Just like clockwork. Yes. Most of it should be good. Oh yeah. Might as well.
More of them! More incoming! Suppressing fire!
Dang it. I was gonna say, no, you buddy, you can stay down. Taking as many of those purple plasma cells as much as I can, because I'm pretty sure I'm gonna be needing them anyways. This is actually a pretty kick-ass cool type of a plasma rifle. The aiming is actually pretty kick-ass too. It's pretty sick. I forget that. Might as well look at it now, just in case. Who the hell knows? Okay. Oh, never mind. I probably did get that. Never mind. Okay. Sorry about that, everyone. Okay, no, just keep on going. Keep on going.
Another infiltrator?
No, he's with us.
Oh, Oh, can't you just feel the whole suspense and intensity? Okay, before I even talk to this guy. Oh yeah, gonna be needing all of that. Okay, just gonna very quickly here. Might as well.
Took you a while. How did you know we were coming? I thought you'd know by now. I know more than you think. Better prepare yourself.
It's quiet.
Spread out!
All right. Going all
focus
full...
Focus on that HK!
Going all full bazooka on this guy.
They're coming from the west gate! This is it. Follow me.
Damn it, the hell. I'm going to see what I can so-called scavenge here. Just gotta check to see what I need to kind of grab here. Oh, yeah, I forgot about that part. Literally all of what I need. Might as well. Yeah, I already have one. I could take that laser-guided missile and probably sell it off for something, but the thing is, what I just... Pretty much after I left that shelter, it was the last time I was going to be back there anyway, so that merchant is already gone. So there's kind of no point to that. Okay, let's see if I can just add a little more to that. Going here.
Central core is downstairs. How do you know? I've been here before. I've seen it. Watch out!
Not gonna lie, that was easy enough.
This is it. Skynet's finished. It's not here. The central core. It's supposed to be right here. They knew we were coming. They moved it. It's a trap. A fucking trap.
We have to move. Those missiles are headed this way.
Wait! If we triggered the attack, it means that this place is still connected to Skynet's mainframe. If we trace where the signal's coming from, we'll know the central core's actual location.
How could they know we were coming?
When Skynet was about to lose the war, they sent an infiltrator back in time. They must have warned them about this attack.
How do you know all this?
Because I went back after that infiltrator. Yes! I've got the coordinates. Let's go! All of this will make sense to you soon, but right now we need to go!
We got this.
Watch out! Commander, Central Core, it's not here. It was an ambush. Commander! You can't die here. Get up! Baron, I've got the coordinates. Can you hear me? Where the hell are you?
Now, back to the Resistance shelter. It was an ambush. Skynet had sent a Terminator back in time to warn itself about the attack. Yep. Well, all of us have played this game before. This is no secret. We already know what the hell is gonna go off. Pardon me. They moved the central core before we got there. But thanks to the stranger, I managed to escape with the information on the actual central core's true location. Looks pretty dead around here. Oh, wait a minute. Well, like I mentioned before, We already know this type of Skynet's invasion was inevitably coming.
Where is everyone?
This goes downhill from here. What do you know? The shelter's door is just wide open, which means any Terminator can walk on through. Oh, wait a minute.
What the hell?
Resistance soldier dead. And Scooby-Doo's down on the count. Yes, he had his last Scooby snack. Yes, this is the saddening part. It's been only 4 fucking hours since teams Alpha and Bravo left. We only can sit in front of our radios and wait for news. I asked the scouts coming in and out, but they all say everything's been quiet. There's nothing else left to do but wait, and it's killing me. I don't ever remember the shelter being so quiet. And now that I mention how quiet it is, the dogs started howling like something bit their asses off. Great. Yeah, it was the beginning of Skynet's invasion into the shelter here. Well, since this guy here is not keeping everything all locked up, I'll just go ahead and help myself, because I'm most likely going to need it anyways. No. Oh, wait. Energy cells. I guess I could take it with me. I could probably get rid of that, maybe we'll see. Can grenades. Oh, this is the very saddening, dreadful part here. Oh, and guess what, everyone? I'm sure you do remember about, you know, Ryan? Guess what? His corpse is not laying in that spot there. His body's not laying there. Therefore, this is the whole end resulting proof right there. You've changed things. You've changed his fate. He still has a pulse. He's safe. He's alive. Nothing to worry about now. Nice feeling along with it, don't you think? Oh, and, I'm sure you remember Aaron?
Aaron.
guess what? Boom. Her body is not laying on the ground dead. In her own blood. She's far away from here. Well, yeah, I did manage to mislead her thinking her husband is in Mexico, but she still has a pulse rate. She's still breathing. She's safe and still alive. Don't have to feel guilty. Don't have to feel any kind of form of regret. She's alive and she's okay. And she's far away from here. Unfortunately, I can't really say the same thing about for these guys here. And, one second here. I'm sure you still remember, all of you still remember Jacob's, little cutie, Jennifer. I should also include Patrick in as well. He's part of it too. Well, boom. Both Jacob's cutie Jennifer and Patrick, you don't see them laying there. Their bodies are not laying there dead in their own blood. Which means, once again, you've changed history, changed their destiny, and put right that once went wrong. They're far away from here, they're both safe, and they're both still alive. Just gotta love these type of positive changes, wouldn't you say? Well, I personally am very pleased about that. Unfortunately, I can't say for the rest, like, this guy right here. Crack this open.
Commander!
Rivers, you're alive.
What happened here?
An infiltrator got in. Brought lots of friends with him. We didn't stand a chance. Since they didn't go offline, I assume we did not destroy Skynet's central core either.
No. No, we didn't. It was an ambush. They moved it before we got there.
So this is it? We lost? We lost this goddamn war?
Not yet.
What do you mean?
I got the Central Core's real coordinates.
You have? I've gotta learn not to doubt you anymore, Rivers.
We need to call Connor. He may still be able to stop Skynet.
Forget it. I couldn't get him on the radio for hours. You need to find him. You need to give him those coordinates.
First, let's get you out of here.
No. You don't have time for this. You have to leave me here.
I can't.
You're not gonna disobey my final order, are you? Before you leave, I've got a confession to make. There's a reason I wasn't so keen on you from the beginning. Remember that list of people Skynet marked for termination? I lied. I told you that you were number three. The truth is, you're number two. Just behind Connor. You took my spot. And for the life of me, I couldn't understand why. But now I know. They're coming. You need to leave, now. Use a vent in the command room to sneak past them. And then find Connor, and give him those coordinates. Don't worry about me. If they come here, I'll just reason with them. I still have a couple magazines full of arguments. Now go! Good luck, Jacob.
And yes, ladies and gentlemen, that was the last time you got connected with Jessica Baron. And towards the end of this game, the results for her still remain the same thing. She disappears, and Jacob holds she's going to be okay. I forgot about this part here. VSB-90. What the hell do I have? Same thing. Okay, I'm not gonna really need it. I can't really sell it off because there's no merchant, so there's kind of no point of doing that. Oh, and by the way, last skill book. Okay, well, let's go ahead. Okay, everything is all good now. Might as well. Pardon That's okay. Everything's gonna be fine. We're gonna make it out of this. God, I hate it when something like that backfires. It's like, shit, and I have to kind of like run away and get out of the clearing right away. It's like, damn it! I guess I could take it. Stay down. Yeah, I think I'll be fine. Surrounded by living tissue. Damn. And guess what, ladies and gentlemen? You're taking this bad boy right here. And the reason being is because... Weapons 5 skill required. Well, I'm already there, so nothing to worry about. Improved plasma Skynet minigun. Unlimited clip size. However, continuous fire will temporarily overheat the weapon. And that's okay, because I'm going to damn well switch this freaking thing out. So, I'm gonna go ahead and... move this damn ship. And... getting this damn thing upgraded. Stability. This will do just sweetly. Excellent. Oh, I'm sure as this one quote that was used in the first Die Hard film by Bruce Willis's character John McClane would say, "Now I have a machine gun." Ho, ho, ho. Well, actually, the late Alan Rickman said that once. Yeah, poor Alvin. He was killed. I forgot this is gonna be the last time I ever see this guy again. Freaking well, stay down. All right, here we go. Time to get out of here. At this point, there is literally nothing here anymore for Jacob to be here. There's no reason for him to be here anymore. Everyone's whacked, everyone's gone. He's just gonna have to go and escape. All right, time to bust out of here. Front lines. I need to find John Connor and give him those coordinates. We can still stop Skynet, that is, if his division didn't share the same fate as mine. Spoiler alert! No, it didn't. I'm pretty confidently sure he's way too good for that. All right, here we go.
The stranger died in that ambush trying to protect me. He came from the future to save my life, and I don't even know his identity. But thanks to his sacrifice, I managed to escape with the Central Core's true location. When I got back to the shelter, I realized that getting that information cost the life of many others as well. I headed out to find John Connor and his North Division to take part in the last all-out attack. Anyone receiving me? This is Sergeant Jacob Rivers, DN46890. Anyone out there?
I'm guessing that's a no. All right. Time to move out and get to Connor's division. As I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for the Lord is with me.
If anyone's hearing this, please respond.
What part of LA this is? Well, I'm sure if that bro of mine, that buddy of mine, who's been raised in LA, he might be able to tell me where this is, provided he's watching this. Anyway.
Is anyone else out there? God damn it.
Look, we got one.
He's wearing a resistance uniform.
Who did you kill to get that, you filthy machine?
No, don't!
Wait, he's human!
Sorry about that, Sergeant. The infiltrators took some of our key positions, so we're extra cautious. If we'd known that you were joining us in the North Division, that would have never happened.
You know who I am.
We all do, Sergeant Rivers. John Connor told us about you. He said you'd come and bring those coordinates.
How did he know I'd have them?
That you'll have to ask him yourself. He's waiting for you upstairs.
Alright, now we have successfully managed to make it to John Connor's base here along with his TechCom troops. So now we're at his shelter. Interesting how these beds are made up. Or set up, rather, I should say. Alright. Wow, this looks kind of cool. Hey guys, I'll join you for the hell of things. So how you guys doing? Nice. Oh, this is nice and toasty. You guys can feel the heat, huh? It's kind of getting hot around here, isn't it? Yeah. Oh, this is really nice. I'm sorry, this is just too funny. I couldn't help pass that up. It was just too funny.
He's the only survivor from Baron's division.
Jeez, endless amount of plasma weapons. This would be like Christmas season for Arnold Schwarzenegger. Considering the fact he's played a T-800 Terminator machine plenty of times himself. Not bad, pretty cool. What am I using these? Those actually look pretty cool. Yeah, I can see Arnold's character using one of these things. Cool, very nice. Oh, M16 rifles. Yeah, well, they're not going to work against machines. Smaller ones, maybe, but big ones, no.
That's him. The one Connor's been talking about.
Nice. Okay. I should, Geez, I'm just looking around everywhere. This is really just... This is funny. Okay, anyways, well, I should get going here. Guess who Jacob is about to meet? Yes. The man, the myth, and the legend himself. John Connor. Alright, let's go ahead and get this guy his autograph and all that nice little jazz. Yeah, I know, he's not exactly in the whole show business, but at the same time, it's like, hey, all of us know who the hell this guy is. Let's go.
Sergeant.
Commander.
Sergeant Rivers. I've been expecting you. I took the liberty of collecting the Central Corps' coordinates you brought us. I hope you don't mind.
Not at all. Are we preparing to attack the Corps?
I've sent a unit to do that. We're getting ready to strike the time displacement equipment. Very soon, Skynet will realize that they're losing this war, so they'll try to send infiltrators back in time to prevent that from happening.
Do we stand a chance?
Thanks to the security codes that Mack provided, we've been able to seize control of an HK tank for the first time. It should give us the advantage against Skynet's defense grid. We'll smash it once and for all. I understand that all this might be confusing to you, so if you have any questions, now's the time to ask them.
You know something? I was just wondering about something here. Something just doesn't really make any sense. Jacob, as in Sergeant Jacob Rivers, calls John Connor here Commander. Well, yeah, he's a very lofty type of respected leader, and to some people look upon him like a messiah. He is like a techcom leader. But Commander? Yet, in something like another type of Terminator games, like Terminator, I think it was like back on the, unfortunately, I can't recall if it was on the PlayStation 2 or Xbox or anything like that. No, unfortunately, I can't recall it. But I do know that in this one type of Terminator game, which was Terminator Dawn of Fate. Yes, Terminator Dawn of Fate. There were other type of TechCom soldiers that referred to him as this.
We're really getting pounded out there, General Connor.
We'll get you back into the fight, Captain Perry. But first you should see what Haven sent us.
Roger that, General Connor. You think the infiltrator was the start of a full-on assault?
Time is the enemy, Perry. Move on.
Yes. General John Connor. Not Commander John Connor. Apparently, in that type of, on those type of game platforms, or the whole story in itself, isn't he supposed to be general, not commander? Because like, I know, like, some of the other officers on those games have referred to him as General Connor, not commander. That doesn't really make any sense to me, I don't get that. Well, anyways, I thought I would just kind of, like, point that out. Just kind of like, wait a minute. Like, this part here, right here doesn't really make any sense. Anyways, so. How did you know that Central Core wouldn't be at the observatory?
How did you know that the Central Core wasn't at the observatory?
Excuse me.
Understanding the changing nature of time travel made me anticipate the most unexpected events. So when I learned from a mutual friend of ours that a Terminator was sent back to our time, I suspected the future I was told would change.
What do you mean?
When that infiltrator connected to Skynet, it warned them about the attack on the observatory. They had to move the Central Core, otherwise they would lose again. Unfortunately, the intel we received came at a cost. But if there was any other way, I would have taken it gladly.
Yeah, because clearly that that Terminator infiltrator from the future came back to that time period and would have had warned Skynet as to what's going to go on and relocated the Central Core. It's like, damn it. Anyways.
Who is the stranger?
In one alternative future, we reached the time displacement equipment and sent our soldiers back in time. Like always, the mission was to assure the safety of the people Skynet marked for termination, one of whom was you. Knowing the importance of your mission, many volunteered to go back, so I took it upon myself to choose a protector from among them, and the one I chose was you. You are the one you call Stranger.
Like I have been mentioning throughout all this time, the future Jacob slash the Stranger. So, why was he targeted for termination? That's a good question. Here's the answer.
Why am I targeted for termination?
You're the one who discovered the true location of the Central Core. You're the messenger of the intel that could lead to Skynet's downfall. I'm sure you'll figure out the rest when the time comes. But right now, I want you to get ready. Tonight, soldier, we stop Skynet.
The front lines. John Connor anticipated everything that's happened. He knew that Skynet would try to deceive us, and he had faith that I'd bring him those coordinates. The name Connor was always synonymous with hope, and now I know why. I have faith that he will lead us through this final battle. Yes. Commander slash General John Connor, or whatever the hell whatever kind of a high-ranking type of title you want to give him. Either way, everyone looks to him. Okay, so now that I've already have, you know, one second here, there we go. Since now that I already have Jacob reach up towards this point here, just for now, I'm just going to end the video right here. And don't worry, we are extremely close towards the end. It's like one mission over and boom, that's it. We're home free type of deal. All right, everyone. Once again, as always, thank you very much for tuning into my channel once again here. This is Mack. Please be sure to show off that type of really awesome type of support for this channel by hitting that subscribe button, like, notification. And if you have any comments and questions, the comments or questions in relation to this, go ahead and throw it in the comment section. Again, we're one mission away, and that's it. So stick around for the next part. See you very soon.